What's going on, gals and guys? My name is Ryan, back with you for another video. Today, we're gonna be doing an upgrade. And what I mean by that is we are going to be upgrading from the Govee, their first version of the TV backlights. And remember with this one, we did have the light bars. I did make a video for this. I will leave a link for it up above right now somewhere. Remember, their first version only fit 55 to 65 inch TVs. So I did do kind of a retrofit version of this video because I do have a 75 inch TV, but they did come out with their second version, the Govee Backlight. Let's get that right side up, the Govee Backlight T2. This one does now, it comes in two different options, the 55 to 65, or you can get it in the 65 to 75. They do not offer it with the light bars anymore, as you can see, which I have no problem with. That's these two little things right here, and then on the other side. I did not like those. The wires were too short. They came from the back of the TV. I didn't like how they set out, so I actually didn't end up using them, so I have no problem. The other main difference, the only other main difference, but the biggest difference is gonna be the camera. So on the first version of the Govee Backlight, this was their camera right here. But now they went to this camera, or cameras actually. As you can see, it has a camera there and it has a camera there. So it's dual camera. So it's reading the picture from two different cameras, enabling it to read a lot more color, a lot more faster, and to match the colors of the screen and much more accurate. So that is one big difference. And again, it is a little bit bigger difference. I remember even with this one, a lot of people were a little hesitant about it. I never noticed it. I put it on the top of my TV. I never saw the thing. A lot of people were like, oh, it's an eyesore. I don't like it up there, blah, blah, blah. So you could actually put it under your TV. That does work too on the bottom, just like you would on the top. But then I also saw somebody go a little bit further. They hated it being on their TV so much. They actually took it and on their entertainment center, I can't remember who this was or I would link it, but they had just kind of a little decoration rock bed and they buried this in there to there. And then they shot it up to their TV. Mind you, you have to have an entertainment center that sits pretty close to the bottom of your TV because you can't have it, you know, so far away, otherwise it's not gonna read those colors. But he had it, you know, it was about like this, I'd say, and it still did about the same as it would connected to the TV on the top or the bottom. So that's an option if you don't like it. Again, I had no problem with it. Some people said it was an eyesore. But this one, I can imagine, will probably be an eyesore to more people. I put it up there, I set it up there, just not plugged into anything. And I, again, don't have any problem with it, but I can assume being much bigger, as you can see, that it will be an eyesore for more people. So that is something you can get creative with. Doesn't necessarily have to be connected to the TV, but it does need to be very close to the TV. If you can figure something out with that, like I said, the rock bed on the bottom might be an option. Anyway, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and install it on our TV. I'm not gonna take the TV off the wall because it's freaking huge, and I don't even know if I could reach it, even with this wingspan. And so most other people would not take off the TV from the wall like I saw a lot of other people on their videos do to make it easy, but I don't see how I can accomplish that by myself as well as a lot of other people. So let's go ahead and get on the TV. We're gonna pull it out. First thing we're gonna do is go ahead and alcohol wipe around it. We will get the camera focused over on there as best I can to the back, and we will get started with the alcohol wipe. See you guys in just a second. Okay guys, here we are. Here is the back of the TV. This is about as far out as I wanna pull it. I don't know how these things hold these huge TVs, but I get a little nervous when you start pulling them out too far. But this is plenty of room. So anyway, we're gonna take these alcohol wipes supplied by Govee for you. And we're just gonna take one and simply wipe down the back. Just as easy as that. Right where you're going to put your LED strip is where you're gonna wanna rub the alcohol wipe, like so. Simple, simple. And you can see, I mean, it does do quite a bit. Ah, and they give us two, just enough to go around the back and the bottom. And again, a little bit of dirt on there. But that is that. Okay guys, now next step, we want to take the strip light. Obviously remember the lights stick out. The 3M sticker on the back is what you're gonna want to stick to the back of the TV. And then on the other end, obviously you can see where the red ends and the wire is, down to the plug-in right there, which will plug right into our control box here. As you can see, this turns it on. You can adjust the light and have it bounce to music on this. But this actually sticks on the back of your TV, so you never really ever use this. The one time you're gonna wanna use this is right away after you get your strip up. You hook it into this, you plug it into the wall, and you make sure that the strip's working. Actually, if you're smart, you would plug this in right now to see if it works, but I'm gonna go right for it. So we're just gonna take it and we're gonna start from the bottom. And what I like to do is let it unroll partway, and then you'll see these throughout it, right? So those right there, you're gonna have to adjust because this is obviously for a side, which would mean the next one would be longer for the bottom. So we're gonna start right here at the bottom right and just go up and over and around and about. What I do is I just kind of pull the red off as I go. Make sure that your cord's gonna reach to where your control box goes. This goes basically all the way to the middle of the TV, so we're not gonna have a problem there. So we're just gonna start like so. And these do come with clips. They recommend putting these clips on your TV. And as you can see, they also have a 3M sticker on that you'd stick to the back of the TV. And then the LED cord goes in there. I didn't use them on the first one. I'm not gonna use them on this one. It's a lot of wasted time. We don't have, right? So let's just go ahead and put this bad boy up right to the edge there. And then up top, right here, you want to make a loop in it so it does not snag the LED light. Then we're gonna take the rest of the rope, make sure you press it. You're gonna wanna press on it for a few seconds to make sure it sticks, bond it nicely to the TV, and then I'm just going to add it up here by feel. And just make sure that it's nice and tight to your TV. And look at that. All the way around to the very end perfectly. Then just make sure that that thing is nice and tight. You're gonna wanna press all over for a solid 10 seconds. Okay guys, can you see me? Sorry, I wanted to get you up close to the back of the TV a little better. Now we have our transformer. As you can see, it has a 3M on the back also. The light strip is gonna go into the bottom. Your camera is gonna go into the top. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna take off this 3M like that. And we're gonna mount this bad boy, but right in the middle here. Might wanna rub it off with your alcohol wipe if you remember, as I didn't. I'm just gonna stick this bad boy right there, as you can see. Now, you have your inputs on the other side, so I can't really show them to you from here, but you're gonna wanna plug it into the bottom. Bam, like so. And now we're gonna take our little camera here. As you can see, at the bottom where it folds is your plug-in. It's USB-C, they give you an extra cord, so we're just gonna untangle this bad boy. We are gonna plug it into the back, nice and snug. All right, now we're gonna go to the center of our TV. Plug that into your transformer on the top. I'm gonna take you guys off the tripod for a second so I can show you something. Up here, on the camera, you see how it has a little notch right there? That needs to sit flush on your TV. Like so. And then the back. And then the back, do you see where there's that rubber mat kind of thing right there? That needs to sit on the back of your TV.
So, as you can see, this little notch right here, you can barely see, that needs to sit flush with your TV, right? And on the back, there's a little rubber grip right there by my pinky finger. That needs to sit flush up against the back of your TV. That way it's gonna be centered and straight. Now, set you guys back on the tripod. One more gizmo, and that is obviously to plug it in, the AC adapter. And all you're gonna do, obviously, is take the other end and it plugs in on this side, right there, like so. And as you can see over here, I did install an outlet behind it that comes with a little mesh insert right here so you can run wires through your wall, and then it comes down and exits right there. So as you can see from my last one, I already had it built in, and right here is a plug-in, like so, bam. Now we turn it on and it is working like a charm.
All right guys, there we go. As you can see, it is working. It is working all the way around. What we do need to do is take a couple of these cords, and all you can do is tape them up to the back. If you want them to look pretty, you could get some zip ties and take your time and fold them up, you know, like something like this, and really hide them well. I'm just gonna simply tape some up to the back of the TV, make it easy. After that, the hard part is over. Now all we have to do is go to the app, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some of these, actually all of these little orange foam pieces, and we're gonna stick them to eight different points on the TV, and then we will go to the app and we will start finalizing everything in the app, which is an easy part. I'm gonna wait until the sun goes down a little bit. That way we're gonna be able to see it a little bit more. I'll put the app on one side of the screen, I'll put the TV on the other. We'll go ahead and set it up so you can see both simultaneously. Real quick guys, before I forget, if you would like and subscribe, please, I would really appreciate it. I wanna continue to do these videos for you guys. And you know, obviously likes, definitely subscribes, help us a lot. So if you would do that, please, I would greatly appreciate it. Enough of that. So let's take a little bit of a break. For me, a few hours, for you, a few seconds. We're gonna rotate the camera. We're gonna get on the app and we're gonna start to finish setting this up to the TV color. All right, so I'm gonna get everything in place and I will see you guys in just a second. All right guys, here we are back. Real quick, before we get to the app, I'm gonna do a couple things. If you look up on the TV, if you can see right here, then over in that corner and up on that corner, I have a couple pieces of tape. If you can see, we have a couple wires that are just kind of hanging. I just grabbed a couple pieces of Gorilla Tape. Put that up and put these little circles or these little ends, flip them back, tape them to the TV, and voila. There we go with the pieces of tape. Now, I have our orange dots and a tape measure. Tape measure, remember we put up our camera. We're gonna see exactly how close it is to dead center, because that has to be right in the center. And it looks like our TV is 55 3/4. So that's like 32 3/8 or something. Huh. I'm not sure you can see this, but it's at 32 1/2. So it's basically perfect. Huh. Wow. All right, so next we're gonna take our orange pads. It comes with 8, as you can see, but we only need 7. We're gonna take them off. They just kind of just pull right off. They're just tiny little foam pads with a little bit of stick on the back. We're gonna put it in the very corner of the TV, like so. We're gonna take the next one. We're gonna put it in the bottom, like so. And we don't have to measure dead center on the bottom here. I'm pretty sure Samsung already did that for us. If you have this kind of TV, I know some of the OLEDs, they put it over on this side, so you might have to measure or just go up with your camera. Then the last two, 37, so 18 1/2, we want to be dead center, just like so. And we're going to snap the last one on in the same place on the other side. And voila, there we have it. If you see now, we have all of our dots on the TV, all the way around, all 7, do have one extra. Don't worry about that one. We have the camera centered up top. Now we are good to go to the app. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get out of the picture, unfortunately. We're gonna put the TV on one side, the app on the other. I'll walk you through adding it. You'll be able to see the TV simultaneously with the light settings and setting up the TV, especially the camera, because we don't want to fisheye those two cameras. It will definitely distort the colors. So we're gonna set that up and I'll show you some other features and we'll be good to go. So let's get the app thrown up and I will be right back. Okay guys, as you can see, we have the app up on one side, the TV on the other. You can see we have it on. I turned it on from the back. We have our orange little foam posit things there and seven spots. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get on the app right now. So we are gonna go to the Govee Home app. If you do not have it, you can get it in the Google Play Store or the Apple Store. What we're gonna do is go up to the upper right-hand corner there with the plus symbol. We're gonna hit that. And look, it already actually found the device. If it wasn't up there up top, we would go to the search bar right here and we would go H605C. And there it is right there, but it already detected it for us. So we're just gonna go ahead and click add. So now it says we want to short press the on-off button. There we go. And we are going to name this Living Room TV Light. We'll start with that. Might change it later, but we'll see how that goes. Got it. Okay, so now it's going to tell us exactly how we want to mount the camera, obviously, install the light strips. Now we want to start the calibration. All right, so as you can see there on the TV, it's going around, it's calibrating. Okay, now it says, please stand in front of the TV and select based on the current lighting. As you can see, we have blue at the top, nothing on the left, nothing at the bottom, red on the right. So we want to choose this one. We're gonna confirm that. Now we are going to set up our Wi-Fi. Mine's already stored in the Govee app. If this is your first Govee product, you'll wanna find your Wi-Fi up top, obviously, and your password down below. You can save it if you choose. We'll hit done. All right, now you can see right there, a new device from our Eero network. That means it did connect to our network. All right, so now we're gonna turn on the TV. I'm gonna go ahead and go to YouTube so we can get the best colors. We can choose our own. Okay, so now is where we need to choose our points with the orange dots from the camera on the app. So we are gonna go next. We're gonna go start calibration. As you can see, I'm just dragging these points. I guess let's give that a go. We'll submit that. Make sure you do it on the left and the right. All right, now it has an update. This always happens. We'll go ahead and update this real quick. Okay, now we're going to switch it to video. I like movie. Now this is where we're going to adjust our saturation and our white balance. As you can see, more over to blue, more over to red. They recommend getting a white screen up and adjusting it to that, but I think we might just want to try this. I usually like to keep my saturation up pretty high. I'll say 80. We'll do that. And don't forget about the moving watching dream view. Now with this, I did show how to add other things. Alexa, turn on the Glide Lively lights.
Okay.
So when you go into the dream view, you can add all these together. See my wall lights. If you have other LEDs in the room, you can sync them. So you could put one on the whole left side of the room above that couch, and then one on the other side above the fireplace, and one behind you, behind the main couch. And you can sync all those up to almost have a color of surround sound, for the lack of a better term. But we're not going to do that right now. Alexa, turn off the Glide Lively lights.
Okay.
And then there's the effects lab. You can go in there and you can change it to certain colors. You can have different themes, festival life. They're just all different color combos. Gaming lights, harmony lab. I don't really ever mess with those. You can have a timer for night, day, to turn it on at a certain time, off at a certain time, different days, wake up, sleeping, blah, blah, blah. They have autoplay, they have snapshot lists. The brightness, of course, is gonna be how bright the backlight is. The mode, it will sync with music. The TV, which is video, color, scenes, or you can make your own in DIY. There's the color calibration right down here. And you can do part or all. And then you can go game or movie, which I don't see much difference right now. Maybe it is when you're playing a game. And then you can also turn on the sound effects with the color changing to the TV. I think that that's a bit too much. It's almost just way too much when it's bouncing up and down and changing colors to your TV. I'm not a big fan of that. That might be cool if you are gaming. I have not tried it. I do have a gaming light with light bars just like this for a desktop computer we're going to do a video on here coming up soon. So maybe it'll look cooler when we're gaming. We will find that out in a future video. But for now, I always leave the sound effects off. Now you can go into your settings. You have your Wi-Fi. You can recalibrate the camera. There's your directions if you need them again. You can hook them up to the Amazon A-Word or Google Assistant, which mine automatically already do. So it's already linked from the very first Govee product that I had. So it'll always link the rest of them. If you don't have it, just click on either one of these two right here, and they'll walk you through the setup. Your firmware version, your hardware version, your MAC address, and your product model. So that's that. And if you want to delete it, and then up here in the upper right-hand corner, that is for support. But we don't need any of that. And I think we're okay. I think we are set up. Okay, guys. It has gotten a little bit darker, I think. I think we're basically done. We went ahead and put the light around back, remember, after we swabbed it with an alcohol wipe. We connected it to the transformer with the AC adapter, the plug-in. Then we put our light smack dab dead center up top. Then remember, we put our orange little styrofoam thingamajiggers around the bottom and corners so we could calibrate our camera, which we then did in the app. We added it in the Govee app. We calibrated, we adjusted our white balance. Okay. I think it's gonna be dark enough now for you guys to check out. One thing that I did notice while I was waiting for it to get a little bit darker out, I did actually watch it for myself a little bit. And I gotta be honest, I do not see much difference from the first version and the second version. With two cameras, I thought there would be a definite, you know, visible difference. And I'm not seeing much of it besides how the light emulates out more. Remember on the last one, it only fit 55 to 65 inch TVs. So we're inside the back of the TV about this much. Now we have the 75 to 85, so it expands out to the very edges of that TV, which emulates the light more outwards. So that is much better. I can say that, but that should be a given. However, the color matching, I might want to play with my white balance a little bit more, a couple other settings, but I did a little bit of that, and I'm not seeing much better of the light color capture that I thought I would. Maybe that'll change though. Up to you guys. Why don't you guys check it out, decide for yourself. Again, guys, thanks a lot. I'm gonna go ahead, Alexa, turn off the living room lights and turn off the lights and let you guys enjoy this for about a minute or so as I disappear. Thank you guys very much again. Like and subscribe. Until next time, peace. Yes, I still have my Christmas tree up.